as a voice cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate and longing for a child that will give
him. I thought about that song that says he wants it all, and I thought about one thing that could hinder us from giving God our all as young people. And the biggest thing that I could think of as young people is fear. Fear can hinder us as young people from giving God everything. The spirit of fear, I mean, it can break up everything that God is trying to do, being afraid. So let's talk about fear. Let's talk about fear. If you could turn in your Bible to Isaiah, the 50th chapter and the 7th verse. Isaiah 50 and 7. And I like this verse. A teacher I used to work with, I used to work at Satchel Paige School, and the teacher that I used to work with, she gave me this verse one day. One day I was just going through some things. I was going through some things in my life on a personal level, and she just took me to the side and asked, did I want prayer? And we just went and prayed, and she gave me this scripture, and I never forgot the scripture. I didn't know the scripture was in the Bible until she gave it to me, and I never forgot the scripture after that. Isaiah 50 and 7. And it says, for the Lord God will help me. Therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flame, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. Amen. Let's just deal with fear for a minute. Since fear is a snare. That's what the Bible says. It's a snare. Fear comes to bind us up and to keep us in bondage so we can't really go forth in God. And the potential that's in us can never be released because of that fear that's holding us captive. Amen. But it says that God will help us. It says the Lord God will help me.
Yes.
Amen. I just thank God for that. The Lord God will help me. Whatever I'm going through, whatever I'm facing, whatever adversity is in my way, whatever stumbling blocks are in my way, it says the Lord God will help me.
Yes.
It says, therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flame, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. When it says, I know, that means you can have confidence that God is going to help me. Whatever I'm doing for God, whatever I'm going forth in, God is going to help me. I don't have to stand up here alone. I don't have to be alone. God is always there to help me. Whatever I speak, if I'm up here speaking, it's not my words, but it's God's words. If I'm up here singing, I'm singing praises to God. Whatever. I just want to talk to the youth tonight. Amen. Whatever you do, you're doing it for God. God is always there to help you. God is always there to help you.
Yeah.
Let's move on to our next scripture. I want to look at 1 Timothy 4 and 12. We know that Paul wrote to Timothy, and Timothy was a young man. And Paul really caught something because he knew that the youth needed encouragement. Paul wrote to Timothy and encouraged him. First Timothy 4:12. And as soon as I get there, we'll be all right. And Paul said to Timothy, he said, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of a believer in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. So Paul said, let no man despise thy youth. Sometimes we feel like as young people that I don't need to get up because I can't sing like such and such and such, and I can't do like they do, so I don't even want to get up and embarrass myself. But you know what? Everybody had to start somewhere. I just want to tell the youth that tonight. Everybody had to start somewhere. Everybody, you know, nobody came out with everything, all the knowledge and all the abilities and all the talents and all the gifts. Everybody had a starting point. and everybody had to learn and everybody had to be trained.
Yes, Lord.
But Paul said to Timothy, he said, you can be an example. There's something working in you, and you can be an example to other young people. You can be an example to people at school. Anybody you come in contact with, you can be an example. He said, in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Amen. So we can be an example. And just moving on, let's go to 2 Timothy, the first chapter. Verse 6. 2 Timothy 1 and 6. And Paul, he's not through dealing with Timothy. He has something else to say to Timothy. He says, when I call to remembrance, well, let's look at verse 5. When I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice, I am persuaded that it's in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou serve the gift of God, which is in thee by the putting on of hands. I just want the youth to know tonight that God has put a gift in you. God has gifted each and every one of you. There's not a man born on this earth that God hasn't given something to. God has given gifts. He's put gifts in the church. And a lot of times, God gives people more than one gift. Amen. God gives out gifts. The Spirit gives out gifts as it wishes. I mean, some people are just so blessed and so talented and so gifted. And I'm talking about y'all. Y'all are so talented and gifted, each and every one of y'all. I mean, I've worked closely with each and every one of y'all. I know that God has put some amazing gifts down in y'all. And I see that the spirit of fear is blocking some of that. The spirit of fear. And fear can be a snare, but it don't have to be a snare. We can work past that. We can work past that spirit of fear. Amen. In the next verse, verse 7, it says, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. God has not given us the spirit of fear. He's not given us the spirit of fear. We can conquer fear. I mean, we are more than conquerors in Christ, more than conquerors. That spirit of fear that holds us captive, I know I've dealt with it myself. I used to get up here and shake. You know, I changed the microphone and didn't know what I was doing. But after a while, I started realizing that it really wasn't me, but it was God. It was God. And I didn't have to depend on myself. I didn't have to depend on my own strength. I didn't have to be the best. I didn't have to be like nobody else. All I had to do was just let God take control. And that's all God wants. When he says he wants it all, he wants you to just let him take control. He wants you to give it all to him. Amen. He wants it all today. I just love that song. I can't stop going back to that. But let's look at Isaiah again. Let's go back to Isaiah. Let's go back to Isaiah. Isaiah, the 60th chapter. We're going to look at the first verse. Time to rise and shine. All the gifts that you have, all the talent that you have, you know what, I'm going to declare right now that the spirit of fear won't operate on the youth that hope deliverance. And that God has given us power over the spirit of fear. Amen. No longer will that spirit hold the youth here at Holy Deliverance captive. We have victory over that spirit in Jesus' name. Amen. So it says, arise and shine, thy light is coming, the glory. The glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. The glory of God is on you all. The glory of God is on you all. The anointing of God is on you all.
Amen.
And I just want to encourage you and tell you that you're never going to get these days back. These days, as young people, you're never going to get these days back. As these days slip away, you get older, a little bit older. Because I remember sitting right there and me and y'all age, and it wasn't that long ago. But when you look back, you wish you had done stuff differently. And you wish you had really gave yourself to God when you had that chance. So you're never going to get these days back. So while God is moving and God is working and dealing with you all, just surrender to God. Let's go to Proverbs. Proverbs, the 6th chapter. We'll start at verse 6. We're going to read down to verse 10. It says, go to the ant, thou sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise, which has no guide, overseer, or ruler, provided her meat in the summer and gathered her food in the harvest. It says, how long wilt thou sleep, O sluggard? When wilt thou arise out of thy sleep? Yet a little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to sleep. And what I want to say once again is rise and shine. Rise and shine. It says, how long are we going to sleep? How long are we going to sleep on God? How long are we going to sleep on this season that God wants to use the young people and wants the young people to go for it?
Yes.
Let's get up, young people. Let's rise and shine. The glory of the Lord has risen upon us.
Yes.
Amen. God has gifted us. So let's operate in what God has for us to do. Amen.
Yes.
Let's go forth in what God has for us to do. And the next verse I want to look at is in Ecclesiastes, the 12th chapter, verses 1 and 2.
Remember now thy Creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them. While the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain. Amen. And what the scripture is saying is that there's no time like now. Amen. There's no time like now. Right now, as young people, we have the greatest opportunity in the world to do a great work for God. Amen. You can do more for God now than you ever are going to be able to do. Amen. You can do more for God right now in your youth. Amen. You're free to give God yourself and give God everything. Give Him yourself in totality. You're free to really go after God and worship God. You don't have anything tying you down right now.
Amen.
If God wants to take you on the mission field in Africa, He can do it right now because you don't have anything tying you down. Amen. By the time you get 18, whatever you want to do for God, amen, whatever God puts on your heart, you'll be able to do it. But it starts now. It starts with that dedication right now, realizing that time is just slipping away from us as young people. We won't always be young. One day we're going to come in here with a cane and a walker, a wheelchair. Some of us, they're going to have to roll in, push in, scoot in. Amen. They're going to have to move the bench for us too. Amen. So these days, I mean, just enjoy these days and soak up all of God you can. I mean, really, let's operate in what God has for us to do right now in the present. Amen. It says that the days are coming where we won't have pleasure.
pleasure in those days. Things are going to get hard. Your body is going to start breaking down. Everything is going to start falling apart. You're going to get hit with bills. You're not going to be able to afford that trip to Africa anymore. So now is definitely the time. While you don't have to pay for your own food and clothes and all that, now is definitely the time to seek after God. Amen. And then in verse 2 it says, while the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened. And then it says, the clouds return after the rain. After it's already, a storm is already passed, and it comes right back. Amen. It comes right back.
Oh, man.
I mean, so really, now is the time. Young people, we free of responsibility. For the most part, you don't have a lot on you. But as you get older, you're going to get some more responsibility. You're going to have to be tied to a job. You understand what I'm saying? Rent. Y'all know about rent. Rent, bills, all that's going to hit you. But now, you have a golden opportunity to do something for God. Amen. Before you get tied down where you can't afford it anymore, your body won't let you go anymore, we can do a work for God and lay up treasures in heaven. Amen. Amen. And the last scripture I want to go to, well, I got one more. Let's go to Romans 13 and 11 through 12. And again, my little theme is rise and shine, rise and shine. I just want to throw that out there one more time, rise and shine. God has invested in us. God has put something down in us, gifts and talents, things that he wants us to use for his kingdom. Romans 13 and 11 through 12. And it says, and that knowing the time, that it is now high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Amen. It's high time for us to rise and shine. Amen. It's high time. Now is the time. There's never going to be a time like right now. What you can do for God right now.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. You can give God. You know, I told a young man, I was on the bus and I was heading home. I had some business to take care of. I was heading home. He stopped me. He knew who I was. I didn't know who he was. But he knew who I was. I found out that we had a friend in common, so he knew who I was. And he stopped me. He said, okay, you Dominique, right? And he began to tell me about what was going on in his life. I guess he knew that by that mutual friend that I was saved or whatever. So he began to tell me what was going on in his life. And he told me he wanted to get right, but he was struggling with that. He couldn't really get over the hump. He couldn't really give his whole heart to God. And I began to tell him that you never know if you're going to have a mind to get right again. This might be your last time. And I told him, just think about the days in between when you don't even have a thought about God. You know, 3 months might go before you think about God again. So you never know.
Yeah.
That might be the last time that you run into somebody that can talk to you about God. Your mind might never be fixed on that again. You might go the whole rest of your life and have not even given God your heart and die and go to a devil's hell.
Yes.
So right now is the time, young people. Right now is the time to give God all. He wants it all for us. Now is the time to rise and shine. Now is the time to let God use you. Now is the time to let God have your heart so you can be with him one day. Amen.
Yes.
That's all. That is.
Child that will give him their all, give it all, he wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate and longing for a child that will give him their